brothers from another land. Yeah, here once again.
Yes.
I want to
come. I'm feeling very cold. Please, just let me cover my head.
Okay.
The weather is not good at all.
I can see, you know, this place, whenever we are in winter like this, it's very cold.
Yeah.
Advise you guys, you know. I advise you guys on something. I don't want to, you know, blow people's mind. Advise you on something. Okay, let's go to the point. I want to ask you something which has been bothering my mind, and I think same applies to people. Maybe they have also been thinking and having the same mentality as I do. Guys, is it good, let me come to you, is it good for a Christian to lodge in a hotel?
Christian lodging in a hotel? Okay, Christian lodging in a hotel, it's not bad to me, you know. It's not bad to me because let me say that everybody sleeps in a hotel. Mm-hmm. Let's say, for instance, I'm the assistant to the owner of Google, you know, and I'm to fly somewhere and make a show. I need to sleep in a hotel. Or let's say even I am the founder of a Fountain Life Christian International.
Wise Multimedia.
Oh yeah, Wise. Now I've become very popular. Everybody's calling me here and there, you know. I need to sleep in a hotel. But then, this is where the issue lies at. The motive at which you are going to sleep the hotel with, that is what counts, okay? Everybody with the idea that he's going to sleep in the hotel. If somebody is going there for some kind of, you know, immorality, those kind of stuff. But if you are going with the idea of positive thing, there is nothing wrong about it. So to me, it's not wrong to sleep in a hotel at all. Actually, hotel is for like your second home, to make you comfortable wherever you go.
Okay, I have a question for my brother. Do you support what he said?
Very well, very well. I don't support it 100%. I want you to look at the situation.
Okay,
a hotel is a place where you, because you brought it in an aspect of a Christian. Don't forget, a Christian. So maybe a Christian has values, has a principle to follow. His dream life to follow a certain type of life. Okay, and this type of life, it should be generally contaminated with anything. I want you to read my lips. It shouldn't be contaminated with anything.
Okay.
I want you to look at a situation whereby William, Mr. X, William, what I want to use names. Mr. X is a Christian and goes to a hotel. Okay. And Mr. Y goes to the same hotel. Okay. And this Mr. Y is not a what? A Christian. Do you know that people who are not Christians, there's a certain type of life they live. See? It is not a mystery.
I have questions for you, both of you.
Okay, you just
Mr. White has a different life of style he lives. He's living a life of immorality, sexuality. He's living, for example, okay, I'll put it in a way that he's living like, let's say, four ladies. Okay, and here comes a Mr. X. For him, he's married. Okay, let's say he's not married, but he's not messing with his life. And It is everywhere that when you sleep with different type of women, there are some spirits that come on with you.
But now, okay, you are going to the hotel, you are not sleeping with the women.
Okay, now
remember that. The Bible said we are in the world, but we are not of the world.
Wait a minute.
So you can sleep in the hotel, but the motive at which you are going in,
okay,
to the hotel,
but it's not happening. Okay, I'll use what this man said as your question. I got some questions from
what he
said.
Okay.
Okay, for a Christian being in a hotel, you know, there are certain things they do in a hotel so badly. Let's say someone will just go in to sleep with a lady. Now, the moment they leave, you being a Christian, you go there. Let's say you go to lodge in there for one day or 2 days to, you know, go and minister. And that kind of spirit is in. Is it? How is it going to
happen? Okay. This is where the thing lies at. He said, he that is in you is greater than he that is in the world. You understand? If other people go there to do their immorality, that is why Bible says pray without ceasing. At every point of time, you have to pray. If you are going to sleep, you have to pray. Sanctify yourself. The blood of Jesus. You have to sanctify whatever you are going to use. Anything that you are going to sleep, you have to pray.
The verse that says, do not tempt the Lord your God. You are tempting
How tempting? How tempting? You are not sleeping alone. You are not sleeping with any other.
Okay, are, you are just talking to the reception, receptionist or whoever he is. Okay, you want a room. Now he will take you to the room. That same time you want to enter the room, people are also leaving.
No, it doesn't happen that way.
Sometimes you might go there and then their time has reached.
When before the book inside the hotel, okay, me I've traveled a lot, I've slept in a lot of hotels, I've slept in Meridian Hotel, you know, La Passe Hotel, go to Egypt, I've been in Egypt for 1 week, you know. So before they give you the room, they make sure the room is clean. New bed sheets, new pillowcase. Fridge is installed.
Who says that
AC is working?
Who says that when they wash the bed sheets, the spirits go out?
My friend.
Yes, washing.
Now listen. Now this is the thing. When those two people go there for their immoralities, the spirit is shared among them. The spirit didn't share inside, it does not share with the pillowcase or anything. Do you understand?
You also you are saying that it's not good. Mm. Okay, let me ask you one question.
So let's say for instance you are a pastor.
Okay, let me ask you.
They send you on a mission to Afghanistan or to China to go and cure coronavirus. Now you go to China, where will you sleep?
No, wait, because
you don't know anybody, then where will you sleep?
No, I cannot come to a country and I do not have, okay, let's say many people who are traveling, there has to be a point of contact. Okay? A point of contact. And a Christian, I believe I have to move with all my mind made up. Because when I move, I make sure the person I'm going to see, okay, and there's an understanding. I cannot sleep in a hotel. I better sleep in at a minister's house than going to a hotel. These two, light and dark, they do not mix. I do not want to compromise my Christianity.
My friend, but
these people are doing all sorts of.
No, but now Jesus was clean when he came. He came and mixed us to make us whole. Do you understand? Mm-hmm. So if he, okay, fine. It is true that the Bible says that light and darkness does not work together. You understand?
Yes.
Does not work together. Mm-hmm. But now, if you said because it doesn't mix, you don't want to go too near to the darkness, how will you change them to the light? You understand? It becomes difficult then to change them to the light.
Then that is different.
I have a question for you. Do you believe that Christians can heal a sick person at any place? Do you believe that?
I believe they can hear.
Okay, so my question to you. Me being a Christian or you being a Christian and you lodge in a hotel, they bring someone to your room. You are in the hotel, you are saying it's not good. But let's say you are in a hotel and they bring a sick person, you know the spirit of God is in you. If they bring a sick person into your room in the hotel, will you be able to help that person through the spirit of God or not?
First of all, I'm very sensitive. How you're asking these questions. You asked me in a hotel, and I told you I do not go in a hotel.
Okay. That's what I'm asking. But let's say, I asked you for the first time, do you believe that you can heal a sick person
everywhere,
that you find a sick person?
Yes.
Okay, you are a pastor.
Yes.
Someone is sick
in the hotel.
Then I can go, because that goes back somehow. I drive something small from instantly. Motive matters.
Yeah, the motive.
No, quote me wrong. I don't want you to use my answer.
No, it is my answer. Okay.
That's the question I have given you.
Yeah, they called me to pray for a person. Mm-hmm. So maybe I'll sanctify myself, fill myself with the blood of Jesus. I cover myself with the blood of Jesus. So that it can lead me. God to lead me. So the moment I enter any kind of spirit, then we cannot bypass. Or else when I reach like this, the spirit of the devil will be consumed.
Okay, let me ask you. So you said you will have to sanctify yourself and cover yourself with the motive that you're not going to do anything in a hotel. But you are going to just pray for the sick person, right?
Yes.
Why can't you also have the same mentality, same motive, same spirit to cover yourself and spread it?
It's very simple. Because I do not compromise my grace, I do not attempt my God, the Lord my God. This is a motive of calling me to pray for a pastor. And you are asking, tell me, Aloysius, if can I use the same theology, the same methods that and ideas, why should I stay in a hotel?
So you are a pastor.
Yes.
And you see your church member coming from a hotel with a guy. You don't know the guy. You just know them, your church members. You see them coming from the hotel. What will you tell them at that moment?
When I see them coming out.
Yeah, because you are saying hotel are meant for bad people. So if you see your general, let's say your president or your vice president, and you see any of your member coming from the hotel, what will you tell them?
I'll rebuke them straight away. I'll rebuke them because me, I did not
know. Okay, first, before rebuking, do you know the motive why they went there? Maybe they went there for evangelism.
Sister and brother.
Yeah.
Maybe they went there for evangelism. How will you know?
Okay, it is upon them to approve themselves, to approve if they are not guilty. If I rebuke them, they have a right to tell me no.
So the moment you see them coming from the hotel, you start rebuking them. Because they are
coming from the hotel.
Exactly. Oh, it is up to them to tell me, you know what? Me, I do not joke with my God, no. I do not joke. It is up
hotel
to them
is
to
for everybody. Hotel is for everybody. You are traveling. Okay, let me tell you. You are traveling. Okay? You are traveling from US to, let's say, to Uganda. Now, the flight has landed in Dubai. They say you have to spend a night before you reach. What will you say?
I'll be in the lounge.
You'll be at the lounge.
If I'm traveling economy class, I'll be in the economy class.
Each and every airline or every company has its own rules and regulations. So if there are rules before you board a flight, if the rules is you delay, your flight delays, you will sleep in a hotel, and you agree with that terms and conditions, there is nothing you can do. You have to be in that hotel. So that moment, what will you do?
My brother, I make sure I do my things in a proper way. I seize that kind of what do they call it? Is it what is a sister? What can I even call it? I make sure that I don't give a chance to that something like that to happen. I make sure if my flight is 8 o'clock, I travel 8 o'clock to avoid such things.
What I mean is, if there is transit.
If there is transit, my friend, why should I board a plane that is going to have a transit flight?
So what? Did Jesus tempted his God by allowing the prostitute to come and kiss his feet?
He did not attempt to.
So why did he do that?
He wanted someone to be healed. The motive.
So he has to be in that mood. He has to be in that environment, right? So that people accept him the way he is. If he had rejected those people,
that because they are married, they are not come together, so they should not mingle together. Then he's not coming to. He said, "Not come because of the holy people. I came because of the holy people." So you have to make yourself available to so that you can at least be friend with these unholy people, so that you can talk with them, you can change them.
My God.
You know, let me come to you. I don't want to it to be like. I'm interviewer, but I want to be one side. But I want to come to you. You know, you said hotel is good.
Yes.
Let me ask.
Maybe I have hotel.
Okay. If you know, most of the pastors, most of the prophets and prophetess, they go to some country programs with their singers.
Yeah.
You know. So if you go with your singer, and they say, "Oh, you don't have any place for this lady to sleep." We have only one room.
We have only one room in a hotel.
Sometimes you go to a hotel, they say they have only one room.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
You understand? Yeah. Mm-hmm. You being a pastor, mm-hmm. and you say hotel is good. Mm-hmm. You know, Bible said leadership by example.
Okay.
Now people know that you are a married man, mm-hmm. or you are single. Okay. So you, as a pastor, you shouldn't mingle with anyone. Now that place is called a hotel. And after program, you went inside to sleep. To allow your singer to be with you in the same room. Will you accept her to sleep with you in the same room?
No, listen.
Thank you so much.
And the name is called Hotel.
The thing is this. When you are going with singers, of course, me.
Okay,
usually if I'm
a singer. Okay. Singer. Singular.
How can you take one singer with you?
No, it's happening because there, you know, every program they have. Okay, today if you are coming, come with one of the singers. We have singers for you. You know, we have backers, so you can go with only one. You understand? It happens.
Okay.
So,
usually, if I go with a singer, I love to hear the voice of male singers. You know, so I usually move with male singers, but not the female.
Okay,
singers.
If in case it happens, yes. For them to
don't try
for you to go with a lady singer.
How lady singer? No, if it's a lady singer. Okay, listen, if it's a lady singer And we go to the hotel and they said there's only one room. It's not a boundary for us not to leave that place and look for another hotel. There are so many other hotels we can look for another hotel.
Okay. It's an emergency. You have to know that.
There is no emergency.
So let's say it's an emergency. There's a time you cannot find any hotel around that place. You know, there are certain places you find only hotel.
If there is no hotel, there should be a motel or there should be a guest house.
So your point is you cannot sleep with that lady. You cannot be with the lady
now,
in the same room.
Maybe the motive still comes. You can sleep in the same room.
Hey,
but
abomination.
What abomination? Mm. If you have not done anything.
Okay, you can sleep in the hotel room with that person.
There's no problem.
If in case you are coming out with your single from the hotel and your member sees you, what will you think? Or what will they think about you?
How would they think about you? Now, before you said you traveled, do you understand? So, which members are they?
No, the people you minister, they are your...
No problem. You are coming out from the hotel, the room you are sleeping, you are coming from the entrance. Obviously, we have different rooms in the hotel. We have one entrance to the hotel. We have one reception to the hotel. So, whether party A is coming from party B room or party C room, that one, there's no problem.
Okay, guys.
Thank you all.
We welcome you to Wise Multimedia. Today is not a studio, so we are not in the studio. So we welcome you to Wise Multimedia as you are watching us in YouTube, Facebook. Just like our page, write your comments there. And I want to finalize it before we greet some people. Okay, you know, they build a hotel to accept visitors, to receive visitors. Any hotel is for those who does not live in the country or those who are looking for a place to sleep. It's not meant for only, sorry to say, in quote, for prostitutes or those who are into ladies or into men. It's for those who are traveling to another country, those who are in the countries and they are finding a place to sleep. You know, you might be in a country, you can be in a country. So maybe your family member wants to visit you and you don't have any place for your family member. You can take him or her to the hotel. So what I would say is hotel is good for everyone.
It's good for everyone.
So we shouldn't judge a book by its cover. When you see someone's coming from a hotel, don't judge the person that he or she goes inside to do this. You know, you never know what the person went inside to do. He might go there to evangelize, he might go there to ask something. So please, let's all understand that hotel is made for everyone. Christians, believers, non-believers, Muslims, everyone. Hotel is for everyone. Thank you very much for all of you, and I do appreciate for your ideas. God bless you. Please, I want you to greet two people. You know.
Two people, you know. Yeah. Thank you so much, all viewers.
First of all, your name and your nationality.
Okay. My name is I'm called Aloysius. I'm Aloysius Chigwe from Uganda. I greet you all, and I want to send my greetings to my precious mother today. Precious mother and my precious dad. I love you so very much. Thank you for taking the responsibility of making me who I am today. God bless you.
Okay. My brother?
Yeah, my name is Brother Selim. I'm from Ghana, and I want to say shout out to all my viewers and listeners. I love you guys so much. Yeah, and my second greetings go to my spiritual palace. I greet you all. May the grace of God continue to multiply upon you. It is under your grace that I'm still sustaining. So I greet all of you. Bye bye.
Okay, I also greet all the viewers, all our fans, and all my family home, and my family also in Dubai. CPIC members, I greet you all. I greet each and everyone who is watching us. God bless you for liking, and God bless you for subscribing. Keep on watching us in YouTube. As you can see, we still have more in store. We will open it for you to enjoy and also, you know, understand certain things. There are certain things we need to open our minds about. So God bless you for being with us this day, and you will be blessed. It's my prayers that God gives you whatever you have been praying for, whatever you are looking for. It's our prayer that God granted unto you before the end of this year. Looking for marriage, looking for job, looking for, you know, financial problem, God will do that for you. God bless you for
watching. God bless you. Bye.